VIP. Let's kick it.
Collaborate and listen.
Ice is back with my brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of me tightly. Flow like a harpoon daily and nightly.
Will it ever stop?
Yo, I don't know. Turn off the lights and I'll glow. To the extreme, I rock a mic like a vandal. Light up a stage and wax a chump like a candle. Dance.
Hello, gentlemen. How are you guys? Enjoying your Iceland experience so far.
Yeah, we are.
We are at the
North American plate
and the Eurasian plate,
the place where they meet.
Pangea, babe.
So I just looked up on Google what the best coffee shops near me were, and the Burjian Cafe came up, so here we are.
What is it called?
The Burjian. Brigian? Burjian. Dude, this is freaking awesome.
Hey, Con.
What's up?
What's it like sleeping when it gets bright at 3 a.m.?
Well, I didn't have a pillow, so I used a blanket pillow hybrid. So it was a little difficult, but Nick and Zach are still asleep, so it seems like it's going pretty well.
Too much Connor butt in that video.
So we're coming to you here from Siljalanfoss.
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 Wrong names only. Skagafogel.
Too many times I saw you cry.
Nate, how are we feeling?
Drone action is a little bit low today, if we're being honest.
This tent rocks. This tent is the boat.
I missed it. Dang it, it's so... Frick, I missed it. Frick, I missed it.
So, Kun just beat me in a really heated battle of darts. One dart was thrown so high on the ceiling that we could not retrieve it without a pillow. Good story, and then now we're heading from some Scrabble with some Icelandic letters, and it's about to get real in here. We're gonna give extra points for immature jokes and spelling our friends' names.
Here we are at Skafta Rildara, hun.
Scared of everything.
Skate around, my flan.
Kick it.
This place is called Pajagaluga Fjord.
I think it's pronounced Pajagalofer.
Ah.
I think Connor's right.
So you might be wondering, how did all these guys get around this town, this island, with such ease, right? And I don't think any of it would have been possible without our noble steed, right here.
Hello, welcome. Let me give you a tour. So, if you look right over here, we have our closet and our storage space. And if you pan a little bit to the right, you'll see where our pantry is. And just north of that is our trash can.
We like our food to taste a little bit like our socks. And then our pants to smell like rotten food.
All right, guys, so as I mentioned, this is our trusty steed here. I think I'm gonna give you guys a little car tour and show you some of the quirks and features that it has. Starting in the front, you can see on the roof some very nice rust spots.
Ooh, crusty.
Quite crusty, but you know, it gets the job done. Also featuring four doors, which is nice. However, three of them don't lock. Coming around the side of the car to the back here, this is probably the best part, right? Featuring a banana peel.
Yeah, oh. It's like a cute little hat.
Yeah, probably the best part of the vehicle here is that we don't have a rear windshield wiper. Also, if you take a close look, one of the license plate lights is being held on by duct tape.
That's nice.
Yeah. Also, the trunk doesn't lock either. If we come around the other side of the vehicle, one of the best quirks about this is that when you're opening the gas tank, right, I pull the lever.
Nice.
So, you know, it's extra added security. If we're trying to open the gas tank, the gas cap, you have to have two people, one to pull the lever and the other to open it. So it ensures that no one can steal gas from you. It's probably the best feature of the car.
Nate, should I have been recording all this?
Skater fell on his skull.
You gotta say it.
I'm saying it. Can you count us down, Dan?
3, 2, 1.
So
I just
no!
As they say in Iceland.
Stupid Americans.
Pretty accurate.
You look at that, look at that. I just need to focus.
No way, but then I pull it away and small beer. Big beer, small beer. Big beer, small beer.
That's bad.
You went earlier.
What's been your favorite part so far?
I mean, we've seen molten lava flows, icebergs washed up on beaches.
Yeah.
3 a.m. sunsets. Sunrises, rather.
Yeah, 11 p.m. sunsets.
Not much lack of sun.
Yeah, lots of sun.
There's just not a lot of people here.
Yeah, there's not.
Like, it just seems like you're alone all the time, which is kind of cool. Mm-hmm. Except for the tourist sites, but like the roads are like, you can walk on them.
Yeah, it's sort of sparse.
Yeah.
Which makes it feel untouched. Unlike a lot of the world, a lot like untouched. Yeah.
You see all these fields, and you're like, there should be developments there.
Used to that, aren't we?
Yeah. So as you can see, we have the ground there and the sky there.
No, it's the other way.
Oh, yeah. the ground there, and there's no line.
So we wanted to go down there, but we could not.
We're making a movie.
We are making a movie.
They offered us millions to be extras, but we said no. We're on vacation.
So we're now on the eastern part of Iceland, and they say that the best part of this is the drive and how you enjoy it.
I really like how you
the amazing mountain.
See the,
but,
the light.
It's still quite hazy.
Yeah, I would say it's maybe quite mysterious.
Oh.
When I was 6 years old, I broke my leg. And I was running from my brother and his friends.
There's Zach. We just had a small moment of panic for him.
They hiked up this here. The other guys thought he went over here, but he went over here and then climbed all the way down. And now he's running on a bridge.
I'm saying if you go up over everything, there's like a couple false summits and like four more waterfalls, and then you get over and there's just this huge windy plateau. And you feel like you're the only person alone in the world. It's amazing.
That's good. We're glad to have recovered Zach, I will say.
I know. I didn't know this, but while I was, you know, enjoying feeling like Adam before Eve was created, swimming in streams and, you know, frolicking on windy plateaus, Connor and Nick were apparently panicking and thinking I had fallen to my death on a waterfall, so.
Woo-hoo!
Zach's alive.
Yeah, screw you, Zach.
Yeah, Con.
Hey, you wanna see me disappear?
Some of the best spots in Iceland are the ones that like the vloggers don't talk about. Exhibit A.
Just getting off the side of the road, climbing waterfalls, freaking your friends out a little bit, and getting some coffee at a roadside shack in the middle of nowhere. Ditch the scouting report. Yeah. fly by the seat of your pants.
Yeah, exactly.
Draft without a plan, am I right? Taste the sweet perfume of the mountain grass I rolled down. I was younger then. Take me back to when I found my heart. Broke it here, made friends and lost them through the years. And I've not seen the boring fields in so long.
Whether you could swim across this river successfully before you get sucked in by the waterfall.
I think you can do it, but you gotta swim downstream to get there.
I think you gotta swim upstream and ride the ellipsis. I think if you go downstream, okay, you're dead. Slingshot.
I think if you go downstream, you're dead too. If I was a betting man, I would bet on upstream.
He's a slingshot.
What's that got?
If you're gonna die someday, like going down a waterfall seems pretty cool.
Kiss on a Friday night. I don't reckon that I did it right, but I was younger then.
Alright, our car is kind of like Waffle House. Even when it's locked, it's always open.
How did we get here? We took a detour to avoid a toll.
A sad toll.
And it brought us to some of the most beautiful views.
Moral of the story, don't pay tolls. Take the road less traveled.
What, did you just farmer's blow, Zach?
That was a good candid moment for the vlog. Yeah. All right. Here's what you got to do when you're traveling to Iceland. Step one, their yogurt is amazing.
It's honestly incredible.
It's just fluffy, creamy texture, amazing.
I'd say next, make sure that you stop at every single opportunity you can on the side of the ring road. Well, first of all, you got to make sure that you actually take the ring road because there's cool stuff all around if you have time. But then, use the destinations as like points to get to, but really some of the best moments that we mentioned earlier are the random stops on the side of the road.
Well, woke up this morning to an email from Delta saying my flight had changed. It's now a day earlier. I've called 8 times now. The issue is, after 15 minutes of being old, I get to that last piece where I just need the flight change. And they say, okay, give me one sec. Radio silence. Line goes dead both times.
So we went to get our COVID test this morning, and let's just say we got a 3 out of 4. So if one member of the team is missing, that is why. Zach, we love you.
Yeah, let's look around. I see 1. I see 2. I see 3.
Hey, you just gotta look at the positives.
Even though things didn't go perfect, and the last day was kind of like a bit of a dud because everyone was leaving. Like, we lost Nick this morning to a flight incident, as previously mentioned.
We lost Zach to something else.
We lost Zach to something, to it that shall not be named, as we are in a public space. And I think it was still an awesome trip, though.
Yeah, I agree. I think at the end of the day, it's, like, cool to go to places like Iceland, but it's, like, it's about being with the boys.
It's at the end of the day, it's about being with the boys. It's not about where you are. It's about who you're with.
Exactly.
And right now, we're actually down 2. So it's a little sad because we're not really with who we wanted to be with.
Me and I are just having some bro-on-bro bonding time.
Last night at a hotel, yeah, the rental car, surprisingly, they didn't screw us over, even though we heard horror stories.
The tide is a turn.
The tide is turning. Yesterday night was a real, like...
That was rough.
It was rough. Zach had to get a hotel room. Nick learned about his flight. Today...
We're smooth sailing so far.
We're smooth sailing. We're excited to, like... be done with all the contracts and stuff that we like had to sign to like do all this. So now we're just in a hotel where it's nothing is our responsibility, and actually the hotel is
really surprisingly nice.
Really nice. So
yeah. I think we're both ready to be home though, for sure.
I'm certainly ready to be home.
Yeah. Great trip, but ready to go back to normal life.
We squeezed a lot in.
Yeah, we did. So did you hit record?